Okay, the next thing I want to show you is one more example here real quick of the type of vegetative, Turkish vegetative patterns the Poles loved. This happens to be found in the Land of the Winged Horseman book, Art in Poland, which is the accompanying volume that went with the Land of the Winged Horseman museum exhibit that toured 7 or 8 years ago. So, what I want to show you here, this is, let's see if I can get rid of this glare without losing the light. This is a szabrak, otherwise known as a caparison for horses. Now, this is another really good example of the different kinds of vegetable and leaf patterns you can find in Polish and Turkish and Persian-inspired Polish garments or accoutrement. And you can see the leafy patterns that are worked into the borders of this this extant object that's on display here. Pardon me. So again, I just wanted to give you a sign of this in case there was someone in our equestrian community who wanted to make one of these, or if you wanted to use it as a basis for some other part of your garb. Let's see. What's the next thing? Ah, okay. Now, the next thing that has direct bearing on us is this here, this painting, this really famous painting known as the Stockholm Roll. This also was on the cover, if that looks familiar. Long time no see. it was done in 1605 to commemorate the wedding of Constance of Austria and King Sigismund III, Vasa, in Poland. Now, this is a really good point that I wanted to bring up. This here is a picture of the coach of the king and queen. And if you look right there in the middle, those are... I can't get it to zoom in. You can see the Elizabethan or English-inspired garments that the court is wearing. This is perfectly acceptable if you want to be Polish. The Poles, the upper level of court society in Poland, wore Western-style garments. You can also see this here. And the king's Drevant Guard, they have Western-style cavalier hats on along with the long pikes, as does the officer on the horse. And here again is another picture of them there. That is completely different than the very Polish-looking Zupans, Delia, and Valency, or the capes that the hussars here are wearing over their armor. I wanted to show you that because it's another extant piece. And you can see again the stars and crescents. Those were real popular at the time. It's another Turkish inspired and Persian inspired item. And I don't know how well this is going to come out, but that star and crescent pattern is worked into in the upper left hand corner on the bow case of the gentleman on the horse here. Heck. So, all right, on to the next item. Now, I'm showing this because this is the inspiration for the Giermak that I'm going to be making for Sir Donegal of Aiton. This is from the movie known as With an Iron Hand, or Zelazny Rekon, and it is definitely rated NC-17. There are some definite adult sexual situations in this movie, so if you get this movie thinking that it's going to be like the Jerzy Hoffman film, with Fire and Sword, you're going to be very shocked because it's very different. It's very gritty, much more adult themed. So, having said that, I wanted to, the reason I'm showing you this is to direct you to the stunning amount of decoration that's going into this. You can see here a definite, what I was telling you before about that the Poles got it, you flaunt it. He's got this ornately decorated undergarment under his Giermak here, which is the outer coat. Which has all the gold braid on it there as the yoke around the neck, and under that is a red jupon that he's wearing. The Giermak itself has all the rows of braids, or rather the little rows of braid and the buttons and the metal studs. And if you can look closely, you can see there's a tassel at the end of each one of them. In a minute here, I'm going to show you some accent objects that match up with this. Now, this is a good example of how you need, if you're going to use a movie as the basis for your garb, you need to double check it with extant sources if that's important to you. And if it's not, you know, just ignore this next section, because I want to show you how you can use movies as an inspiration for something and then double check it if you are interested in being historically accurate. I'm going to advance the movie here for a couple of frames because I want to show you the side of this garment because it's closed. If you can see there on the sleeves, right there on the left here, those are rows of braid, and the big knobs that are sticking up are buttons that hold it shut. The sleeve itself is actually open all the way up to the top of the shoulder seam. I have another seam here that I'm going to show you that will show you that. So if you give me just a moment, I'll get on to it.